What do you think a lucid dream is? You've experienced it more.
Yeah, definitely. What you said, it's you're aware that you're dreaming, and then you get to the point where you practice it enough, and then you get control of your dream. To be lucid means to be aware, to be in control, kind of to know where you are and who you are. So being aware and who you are and where you are and blah, 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 in a dream means you're like, I'm in a dream right now. Some people wake up right away when they realize that, but with practice, some people can, like me, and I know you've had some yourself, can stay inside the dream and make it last long. Dream time can feel longer than real time too, so that's pretty interesting. And it's not as easy as like, oh, I can just make things appear at will. It's like, that takes practice too. Like when I first started, I just kind of explored the dreams and tested it out, but I would always wake up because I get too excited. But fast forwarding, since we're going to talk more about our own experiences real quick, basically then I got to the point where I could start manifesting things in the dream and actually changing the environment. So one of the more interesting ones I had, basically it started out, I was in the middle of this jungle, in the middle of a clearing, and I was with my friends, my mom, and some other people. And I knew I was dreaming instantly. I don't know how. That was at the point where I was just still able to explore the dream, but I wasn't able to really do much else, just interact with the environment, that was it. So I picked up like this weird sci-fi looking gun off the ground, and there's these strange creatures running past us in ghillie suits. They're like almost like aliens. I picked up one of the guns and we started leaving the forest, and all of a sudden we were inside like this abandoned building that was in ruins, and there's like fires on the ground and stuff like that. I walked past like dead bodies on the ground, and keep in mind, I know I'm dreaming, but it's seems so real. And anyways, I end up in my brother's house, my brother's living room for some reason. And my friend's dog is there. And there's like a bigger version of her that's like a different color. It's like white. His dog is actually black in real life, but it's a white dog, a white pug. And then there's a medium-sized one somewhere else.
Like so it was an albino pug.
Yeah, exactly. And then I go outside into where the backyard, they have this patio. There's a table there and there's this ice chest. And inside the ice chest, there's a giant scorpion that kind of looks like a lobster. Like, it looks like a sea creature, but it's a giant scorpion. And even though I know I'm dreaming, like, in the dream, I'm like, you know what? Nothing can hurt me. It's just a dream. It's not real. I wanted to pick it up, but I was too afraid because it seemed so realistic. And then one of my friends, annoying friends in the dream, he picked it up and threw it at me, and I got scared and jumped back. I ran away from that. I locked him outside because I was like, I don't want to wake myself up and get too scared. I want to still enjoy this dream. So I went to the garage part, went outside to the front where the grass and yard is. And then there's mailbox. I pulled out a bag. I pulled out a bag inside that bag and another bag and another bag. And then there's these pictures of like my nephew in like a Captain America costume that I made, even though he never wore it in real life ever. So that was that dream. Have you had any lucid dreams?
You know, I think I've recognized that I was just awake in a dream, but I can't pick out something particular. You know, it usually happens right after I've woken up and then I go back to sleep. Yeah. That's usually when I know consciously that I'm falling back into a dream, right?
That's actually and, the most common.
I mean, that, this is going to sound kind of embarrassing, but just like things that you can control, like you wish you, like having a relationship or stuff like that. When I was younger, I guess, you know, making out with a girl or something, like you just know, and then specifically your crush or something like that. That was something that's happened before.
Yeah, were you like aware of it and stuff? Like you knew you were dreaming and stuff?
Yeah. And I consciously knew that, you know, I was, you know, bringing into my life this girl or something that I had in the classroom or something.
Well, it's funny. I've had, you know, now I'm going to jump into a lucid dream. I was trying to convince you that we were in a dream, and I was going to see if like it was possible to make someone else in the dream aware that we're in a dream, you know, just to see if that would work. I said, do you realize what this means? We're in a dream. And you just didn't believe me. Like you were like in complete denial. I did different demonstrations to show that we weren't in the real world. So like I picked up a solid metal spoon and I said, you can bend this. All you have to do is believe that you can control the spoon, bendable and soft, you know? And I did it and it bent right in front of your eyes. And you were like, what? You were like blown away. I was like, yeah, dude. I looked at a clock. I said, look at this clock on the stove. And then look away. It said 8:09. And then when you look back, the clock changed to 9 o'clock instantly. Because clocks change in dreams, you know, it doesn't make sense. So, and you were like, you're just like, you just reacted. You're like, what? I said, in dreams, clocks never stay the same. And then at that point, I felt like I was convincing you. I was like, okay, he's starting to believe me. And I went on the patio, knelt near the ground, and then I picked up like this rock, random chunk of, actually no, it was a chunk of wood. And I was like, in a dream, you can eat anything you want. And I took a bite of the piece of wood, and it tasted like chocolate. I was like, here, try it. And you're like, damn, it does taste like chocolate. And then I said, okay, let's try something. Let's try to make it stop raining. So I lifted both my hands up in the air as if to push the weather away, like the clouds and stuff. And then slowly it started turning into blue skies. And then we just kind of admired the beauty for a second. Basically, like if you're lucid dreaming, you get too excited about something, you'll wake yourself up and it ruins it. So I was like, you got to stay calm. If you make any sudden movements, you wake up because you make your body, you move your body when you're in bed. And then you remember this, I saw a priest in the bar. You just, all of a sudden you had an apron on, you were going behind the counter just doing it. You're all happy to be in the dream and happy to be a bartender in the dream for some reason.
What?
Like that's what you chose to do. And I told the priest, I was like, have you ever wondered if this is another dimension? You know, like you're in another dimension. I mean, have you ever thought that? And he was looking at me puzzled, like what the hell is he talking about? I was like, have you ever wondered if dreams are connected to other dimensions outside of space and time? And then all of a sudden, everyone in the dream just stopped and looked at me.
It's almost like the dream is trying to deceive you. But then when you realize that you're dreaming and you try to tell other people that, they turn against you or something.
Yeah, isn't that weird? And that's not the first time that happened. I was in a section of a hallway where it's like an aquarium way in the far back. And I was with a friend and someone else from a movie. And I was like, we're in a dream right now. My friend's voice started whispering in my ear saying, you're in danger. They're coming after you. You shouldn't have said that or something. And all of a sudden, I just started trying to fly away in the staircase section and run away. When I ran up the stairs, I went into this gymnasium playroom with all the foam padding, puzzle pieces on the floor, and the ball pit, and a whole bunch of children playing. And there were some children there with intellectual disabilities too, which is really weird.
What if you get stuck inside of a lucid dream? Like
I had that happen once. Like I was basically it's a zone of